It's summertime, and that means if you have a dog or a cat, they're going to shed. So what do you do about it? Well, Sam Champion went and talked to America's favorite vet, Dr. Marty Becker, and he has a way to stop the fur before it flies.
Now, we're getting help today from Louie, who has found a home but was an adopted dog, which is a golden, is that my
it's
right?
Part pony, part golden, but actually it's a purebred golden, but a large size.
Okay, and Shane, who is still
Yorkie.
Available for adoption. Okay, now when we say kind of the three C's, you've got them cut back, collect, and contain. So let's deal with the cutback first.
First of all, every dog is going to shed.
No matter what it is.
No matter what the breed. If you're looking to adopt a dog that's the least shedding, this is going to come as a surprise to you. You want a long-haired dog, not a short-haired dog. Because long hair is actually genetically triggered to fall out less often.
Ah.
So poodles, Afghans, less often
than
pugs and Labradors.
Absolutely right. I would have looked at the long-haired dog and said no.
Yeah. You want a long-haired dog and a small dog.
Okay.
Small dog, there's just less hair to come out.
Shane's perfect.
So perfect. Long-haired, small dog. Keep them clipped short.
Now,
if you already have a pet, you're not looking to adopt, though. How do you, cut down on shedding? Here's what you do at home. First of all, you want to have them shed at a time and place of your choosing.
Right.
At Almost Heaven Ranch in the summer, we do things out in the yard. I don't mind hair in the grass.
So you'll take the hair out of them in a place that you choose.
Right. Time and place of your choosing. I do it in the garage in the winter
time. We're not plucking them, but what are we doing?
And the other thing you do is you want to use a lot of elbow grease. If you're massaging them or you're bathing them, really get in there because all the hair that's going to falls out then.
Okay. What's our little tool here?
This is the mother of all shedding tools. It's called the Furminator. This has a little teeth in it with a little kind of a razor blade, and you run it through.
It doesn't hurt.
It gets rid of the undercoat. That was taken out of that dog in 1 week.
So it
ends up in the trash.
And that's a dog like Louie in 1 week.
Like Louie.
Okay.
There you go,
right. Louie.
Louie,
all right?
You can go back to your mama.
I'm going to go back. Louie's got to bye. Okay, now when we want to kind of collect it, what are the best ways to do it?
This is the Bissell Shed Away. This fits on any vacuum. So see, this thing is actually a shedding blade, what we call a shedding rake. You simply groom your dog with that, and the
hair
goes up in the vacuum.
You're vacuuming the dog with that?
You vacuum the dog or the cat with it. It actually doesn't make much noise. It works very well. It fits on any brand of vacuum.
Okay, and now I've seen these on TV, the little things that roll across the couch.
Oh,
does that work?
I love this thing, because normally we're using a roller, a little sticky tape roller.
Yep.
This is the Pledge Fabric Sweeper for pet hair. This hair that's in this chamber right here, this was taken off our bed in about 2 or 3 days, because we have a pet sleeping bed with us, of course.
Of course.
So you just take this little thing, and it has these two little rollers on the back here, and one goes one way and one the other. So one picks up the hair. When it goes back the other way, it takes the hair off and puts it in this chamber.
But it has Marty's seal of approval, because it actually works.
That's from Cora and Cody right there off our bed.
Contain.
Okay, here's one thing. You know you use Bounce in your dryer to keep static clean. You don't want your clothes sticking together. The good thing about this, what it does is it repels hair. So if you use this on your clothing.
Do you just rub it on?
No, just in the dryer.
So
dryer. Or you can take this and rub it on your upholstery in your car, or on your, the fabric on your couch.
Right.
It also repels pet hair. A little trick, by the way, if you have embedded hair in your upholstery or in your.
Those hairs that won't brush out?
What you use, a little latex rubber glove or a balloon, blow it up and rub it, and the opposite thing, sticks up,
the static electricity,
and then you can vacuum up or clean it off. Not bad.
All right, Marty, as always, let me shift a hand here on Shane.
Thank you
so much.
You love the dogs. You want to adopt them. Great. Lewis and Shane came to us from the Humane Society of New York. You can go there and you can adopt those dogs. You can find out more about anti-shedding products on our website, abcnews.com.